I'm about that life. If you want to be about that life, connect with us on social media. Like and follow us on Facebook and Instagram at Live That Life Now, on Twitter at Live That Life 20, and at YouTube That Life. Contact us via inbox, DM, or email at livethatlifenow@gmail.com with feedback or show topic ideas.
Every time we look up, we want to see you winning.
Live that life now.
Greetings, greetings, greetings. Are you ready to let it go?
Let it go.
Can't hold it back anymore. Turn away and slam the door. It's funny how some distance, and I love this part of the song. It's funny how some distance makes everything seem so small when you start to walk away, back away. The problem gets smaller and smaller.
Yes.
The issue is we can't let go. We got to be upfront and personal. And that's what causes these things to be so big. And the fears that once controlled me can't get to me at all once I do what? Let it go. Let it go. That I love that soundtrack, Frozen, Let It Go, that song. We as a people are guilty. We are guilty of holding on to baggage through holding on to our deep emotions and feelings.
Yes. It's hard, you know. When we talk to a lot of people, and one of the things that has come up a lot, which is why we're doing this episode, is because people want to know how to just let things go.
Yes, easier said than done. It's hard to walk away from different aspects, from relationship, careers, but the key to it, the key is it's the emotion.
Yep.
That's what it's hard to let go. It's the emotions. And something that we talk about all the time is triggers. Triggers cause sparks back up, and we begin to hold and we begin to sink deep in thought because of a trigger. And I say it all the time. So many times we overthink or we think too much.
And what happens is it causes us to be stuck. So when people say, you know, I want help with getting unstuck, a lot of times it's because when you're struggling to let something go, that's the part of being stuck.
Oh, yeah.
It causes you to be stuck. You're stuck in whatever that situation is, that time period, whatever it is that you're struggling to let go of, you're stuck right there.
A person cannot move ahead if their thoughts and visions are focused on the past. I say many times you cannot truly drive, always looking constantly
in the rearview mirror.
You cannot truly move forward. And the truth is, emotionally, physically, spiritually, people don't know how to become unstuck.
They don't.
When we refuse to let go of something, it is because we refuse to see what life is trying to teach us. Wow. We feel stuck because we can't see. You know, we are a people that we got to know the beginning and the end. we sometimes, you know, we get a book, we go into the back to almost see how it's going to end, to see if it's worth even reading, or ask somebody else, well, how was the movie? You know, what happened? Was it really good all the way through without taking the chance? And sometimes life, you just have to go through. you physically have to go through. Sometimes it takes time to overcome and become unstuck, but you got to go through.
Mm-hmm. You know, one of the things that I think that sometimes, you know, it's not always things or people that people are holding on to that they just cannot let go. What I've seen, I've talked about this a lot. I feel like, you know, yeah, it's relationships. People are struggling to let go of relationships. They're struggling to let go of hurt, pain, things like that. People are struggling to let go of mistakes that they've made, mm-hmm. things like that, and move on. But a big thing, it's not always those tangible things, you know? I find that people are struggling to let go of 2019. I think that is a big thing.
When you say 2019, you're talking about the way life was.
I think that especially in 2020 and 2021, I used to hear people saying so much. They would say, I can't wait to get back to quote unquote normal. Right.
And normal is we were fixed.
Yeah.
We were
and when,
fixed.
When they
on
were
how
saying normal,
be.
They were referencing the 2019 normal.
That's what I'm talking
right?
about.
Right. And they kept saying, I can't wait. Basically, they're saying, I can't wait to get back to doing things the way that I used to do things, right? And it's like now, here we are in 2022, and people are still longing for 2019. When the reality is, we're never going to see 2019 again.
And,
it's gone.
And COVID has just brought change.
Yes.
It's sad to say it has happened, but there's so many changes.
Yeah.
And now we need to let, as you say, the 2019 things
mindset,
that, was, yeah,
that normal,
it
that way of life, let it go. Because what happens is you get so consumed with mourning. Because let's be clear, there are some 2019s in our lives, some things that we want to get back to the way it used to be. We cannot let it go. We cannot realize that it's gone. You know, and we get so focused sometimes on the way that things used to be that we cannot see the new things that's in front of us, right? And because you're so consumed with that, you're missing out on what's happening in 2022 because you cannot let go. And like the song was saying, you know, when you put some distance there, you start to see that thing was small anyway. It wasn't even that big of a deal.
Oh, that is powerful. Even when you're talking, I'm thinking of even relationships.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm talking about good relationships. Mm-hmm. Don't get me wrong. We always talk about growth and development, but I'm not the same person.
Mm-hmm.
I was in 2019.
Yep.
And so if you're still looking on that fixed person of me,
yep.
not understand my growth and development, that I go through stages and I am transformed
mm-hmm.
to the person I am in 2022, we're not going to work out because
let
you
it go.
Want,
let
you
go that
want
old
the
version
2019
of me.
Version of me. And I have like the cell phones. I mean, they upgrade.
Yeah.
What is it called when you had to get it? Because it seemed like Apple trying to make us always mm-hmm. get a new one. So we got to get the new version
yeah.
or after a while, your phone will not update no
exactly.
more because it's what? Outdated.
Exactly.
2019 is gone.
And that's the thing. You know, it's our surroundings, our circumstances, your level of access to certain things has all changed, but you haven't been able to grasp that or to let that go or accept whatever is new and move forward because you're so focused on wanting things or getting things back to the way that they used to be or the life that you used to have
yes.
or the way, the career that you had or the relationship that you had or the way you used to work or the way you used to do this or that, you know, and so you're focused on what you think oh, something should be or the way you think it should be and you're stuck. You can't move on simply because you don't, you can't let it go. It's like you said, you're holding on to expired versions of things.
That's right. That's right. Now, one thing that we also as a people hold on to is hurt.
Mm-hmm.
We hold on to
yep.
the hurt, the people that hurt,
yep.
how we felt. And again, let's say we got hurt in 2019. Today, every now and then something triggers and that hurt comes back. And even errors and mistakes we've done ourselves,
yes.
we are still
we holding
hurt.
On to,
we are holding
to our
on.
Mistakes, you know. But, you know, we talked about, like you said, we talked about relationships and past hurts and mistakes that we've made, all those things, a time period in our life, like 2019, that was so good and we
right.
can't let it go. Especially when you think about like past hurt and pain, you know, logically, when you look at that, you would say, Why do we hold on to that? Why do we want to continue to feel hurt and pain? You know, but it's because it's not easy. So why is it hard? Why would you say it's hard to let go in general?
Oh, I mean, it's hard because we want what we had before the hurt.
Mm-hmm.
Because usually everything was good, mm-hmm. or everything was great. Even our own
if it wasn't good, though, sometimes we hold on out of habit.
Well, we don't like change either. Yeah. We don't like change.
Right. We hold on out of habit because that's what we're comfortable with. Like, I'm using the 2019. That's what we were used to. Now, the new way, 2022 way of doing things may actually be better.
Yeah, but we have.
But we're so conditioned.
We would have to be transformed.
Mm-hmm.
We don't. Again, that's change.
Mm-hmm.
We're not ready to change. People, you know, people will be in a bad relationship to not be in a relationship at all. Because
mm-hmm.
to not be in a relationship is A, I'm alone.
Mm-hmm.
That means I have to be back on the market to date all over again. I don't want to do all that. I'd rather be with him that abused me or hurt me and this and that, because we accept the hurt. We are stuck.
Right.
And we got to get out of that.
So again, sometimes we hold on just out of habit, out of this is what we know. You know that saying, people say the devil you know is better than the devil you don't know.
Exactly.
And that's really just a fear of moving forward or change or the unknown. And so sometimes, like we said, fear is another reason. Sometimes it's habit, but sometimes it's fear. Sometimes we're afraid.
But what are we afraid of?
We're afraid of the unknown. So you're afraid of change. You're afraid that what's going to happen to me if I let this go or if I let this person go? You know, that's fear. You know, you're just afraid because you don't know what life looks like outside of that. So like with 2019, it's like holding on with everything I got, because I know that I'm used to that. You know, I don't know what this new life looks like. And so fear is another reason. But you said something when you talked about the relationships, and you said sometimes people stay in relationships, even though it's not a good relationship. It's right. Like, well, I'd rather do that than to be single or to be by myself. So I think another reason that we find it hard to let go is sometimes we have associated our self-identity, the way we view ourselves and the way we want other people to view us, by, you know, the things that we own, so our material things, by the things we've accomplished, or by other people in our lives or status symbols in our lives. So if it's like, well, I'm married, or I have children, you know, it's like you view me as I'm a wife, I'm a husband, I'm a mother, I'm a father, or I have this material thing and I have that material thing. So some people literally will hold on to things they cannot let go because of the perception, the way that they view themselves. They've really, and that's sad when your self-identity is tied to another person or a thing
or another decade.
Yeah.
Like, another year.
It's sad, but it's real, because some people literally cannot let go of things.
Yes.
Simply because their whole identity, the way they view themselves and the way they want other people to view themselves, is tied to that thing. So if it's that marriage, it's like, well, I can't leave this marriage because the perception, the way it looks, you know, or I don't want to leave this house or, you know, walk away
You're
from
tied
this
to
house,
the house
because
You're tied to the marriage.
This is one of the things that I've associated with me, the car, the material, whatever it is. So I think that's another reason we've associated who we are mm-hmm. with some of these things. And that's why it's hard to walk away.
We're comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
We're comfortable. And so we stay out of being, like I talked about, being fixed and in a fixed stage mm-hmm. where
nothing
changes.
Well, that's the
changed.
Habit part yeah. I mentioned. We right. stay out of habit.
Our behaviors are so deeply ingrained in us.
Mm-hmm.
And the things we do, like you say, out of habit, we just don't want to change because we can't even see farther down the road.
Right.
We're not even willing to look.
Right. Another reason that I think is hard for, you know, for people to let go is some people literally, they can't let go. When someone has wronged them, it's hard for them to let go because they have this need for the person who wronged them to pay. And it's like, I want you to know you did me wrong, and I want everybody else to know. Mm. And if I feel like if I hold on to this, then I hold you to what you did. And sometimes they feel like if I let it go, then I'm letting you off the hook.
That's
and
dangerous.
I don't, yeah, and I don't want you to be off the hook. I want you and everybody else to know what you did and how you was wrong. It's almost like I'm going to shame you.
Yeah.
Sort of thing. So I think that that's, you know, that's another reason. Like, they just feel that they want to make people pay. And so that's why you holding on to that hurt and that grudge, because you you know, you want that. But there's a quote that says, if you spend your time hoping someone will suffer the consequences for what they did to your heart, then you're allowing them to hurt you a second time in your mind.
Yes. Emotionally, yes. Even. Not just your mind, even emotionally. Mm-hmm. You are allowing them to continue.
So you're saying it's allowing you to even hurt a third time.
Yeah. It's a continued effect.
Yes.
I've known people to have moved on in new relationships, but are still being this person that are trying to down another person and talk about their past and their issues where mm-hmm. we're talking about you, if you moved on, mm-hmm. let it go.
Let it go. Another reason that I think that people find it hard to let go is because you always say they're just addicted to the drama. You always say they're addicted to their own story.
Because they have nothing else to say. They have moved on in a new relationship, but are they really happy? You know, are people
well,
really
no, not
happy?
Because if you haven't let it go, you're not over it. You haven't healed. You're not
doing that new relationship an unjust.
Yes, you're definitely doing it
because you're not fully there. You're always looking in the rearview mirror and talking about it and bringing it up. Now, that's one thing if you still have feelings and emotions, but then you should probably not be
but
in this
you need to deal
new,
with that too. Exactly. Yeah. Yeah. But the thing is, like when we say, you know, some people are just, they haven't let it go because they're addicted to the drama of it all and the emotions that come with that. Some of the attention that we get from the drama, whether yes. it's positive or negative attention, people get addicted to that. And, you know, this thing has become so big in our lives. We put so much life into it. Sometimes you don't even know who you are outside of the drama. Like, who am I now? When this is gone, like, this has become such a big and present thing in my life, and I've associated my self-identity with it, right? Who am I even outside of this? They don't even know what the other side looks like.
It's so funny that people, I've known people that have a 2019 experience or something in the past, relationship, this or that, mm-hmm. and 2 years later, 3 years later, they find themselves not even consciously mm-hmm. in conversations about it to people.
Still talking about it.
And not even realize that yeah. they're talking about it. And that's what's powerful because in their mind, they moved on physically, but not
but
emotionally.
Somewhere in their heart. And
they
in
have
their mind.
Not. And so they could be talking about this or that, and it comes up. And sometimes, you know, true friends, you know, when you're in that conversation, you need to tell them, you know, you don't sound like you're over that. Mm-hmm. You say you're over that, but every time we talk or every other time we talk, you still bringing him, her, that job, this, that. You done left the job. You done moved somewhere else, but you still talking yeah. about there's something going on that, and it's not always a trigger. It's just something that's rooted in
that's
them
true.
That will not allow them to let go.
Because they haven't let it go. Yeah. But what that does, when you hang on to the past, it steals your experience of the
present. Yes.
Right? So you are not fully present in the present moment, you know? And so what you have to do is you have to view that stuff as a lesson, basically, so that you can experience the present. Because what happens is when things happen to you or things that you've created, like sometimes, like we said, the things that you can't let go is the mistakes you've made or whatever, you can choose. That is what it is. It's in the past. It's happened. Whether it happened to you or you did it to yourself, you can't change that. So you have an option to let it linger and just, mm-hmm. you know, or you can just say, I'm going to choose to view this as a lesson so that I can experience a better present. Right? Right.
You have to learn to let go. You have to learn to let go. What I'm saying is it's a process. And every situation is different. You need to attract a better you, a healthier you. Mm-hmm. And once you do that, you attract better people in your life. Don't be afraid to meet new people because somewhere in 2019, you had a bad instance, you had a bad relationship mm-hmm. and think, oh, it's me. No, you have to let that relationship, those feelings, those emotions go and be ready to move on to a healthier you, to a better you. And once you do that, you will bring in healthier people.
Exactly.
You will bring in new people. You'll be able to do things differently.
Well, yeah, because letting go gives you the opportunity, like you're saying, to create better relationships with yourself and others. But also, like you said, it creates space for something new to come in.
Yeah, that's the key.
You know, when you got all that stuff that you just holding on to, it's taking up space in your life. It's taking up space in your heart, in your mind. And so when you're letting go, it's creating space for growth, for you to continue to grow, because you're not growing, you're stuck.
Right.
Like you said, if these things are always coming up in your conversations or whatever, you're stuck. You're not able to grow. And so when you let go, it creates space for you to grow. It creates space for you to receive new people in your life and new opportunities. Because a lot of times when we're stuck, we can't even see what's right in front of us, right?
Right.
Because we're too busy holding on. So we can't move forward. Like you said, if you're looking in that rearview mirror, you cannot move forward, meaning you can't grow emotionally. You know, you can't, you know, you can't accept when there's a new opportunity, when there's something new changes happening all around you because you're stuck in the past and you're unable to let go. So, it's just.
That. And people don't understand when you are there, especially not sometimes realize. Some people know and some people don't know. And that's how you come with physical sicknesses.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you always
not letting go.
Head hurts, stomach hurts. You start bringing these physical conditions up on you. Mm-hmm. And then mentally you become, you know, anxiety, depression,
yep.
Suicidal thoughts. A lot of things become because you're in a very dark place.
And that stuff festers and it manifests itself in other ways.
Yes.
And so one of the key things that you need to think about letting go is that it's something that you do for yourself, not others. Similar to like forgiveness, you know, just like forgiveness, letting go frees you. It looses you, right? Because like you just mentioned, the triggers and how they can make you sick. Who wants to be constantly triggered, right?
Right.
So letting go gives you freedom. And, you know, it literally frees you up so that you're able to experience life the way that you should. When we learn to let go, we free ourselves of the source of the pain, the cause of the pain, the suffering, all that stuff that's holding us back.
Yes, very much so. You know, Erykah Badu, I love Erykah Badu, especially this song, Bag Lady. And man, I want our listeners to just listen to this as, you know, she talks about, what are you doing? What are you doing with all these things you're holding on to? Listen.
I guess nobody ever told you how you must hold on to.
You're gonna hurt your back dragging all those issues, emotions, those feelings. I mean, day after day, week after week, year after year. One day, all them bags gonna get in your way. All those emotions, like you just said, all those things is gonna stop you from seeing your present, for being present, or even moving into the future. So what do Erykah say? Pack light. You gotta pack light. You gotta start letting some of those things go. And I love this part. She says, I guess nobody ever told you all you must hold on to is you. You know, you got to remember the job, the man, the woman, the dog, the cat. All you got is you. And if you not taking care of you mentally, physically, spiritually, who will? You got to let it go.
She also said you're going to miss your bus. You can't see it coming because you got too much stuff. That's what I'm saying. You're missing out on opportunities and new experiences because you got all them bags you holding on to.
And again, she is preaching there. She is preaching there. Philippians 3:13 says, this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are what?
Behind.
Forgetting those things which are behind. And then what we got to do? Reach.
Forth.
See in front of you, not behind you, into those things which are what? Before us. We got to look towards the hill from which cometh our help and not keep going back. The word forgetting in Philippians 3:13 means dismissing from the mind and not paying no more attention to those things that hurt us, those things that it did what it did. We lived that life. You know, we ain't getting that back. But what we need to do is let go of this thing that hurt us. To forget is this way to stop dwelling on that negative part of our life. We have to make sure that we understand that the word is telling us to move forward, to move forward. Erica Badu is telling us to move forward, to let it go. Frozen soundtrack is telling us to move forward and let it go. Nobody is stopping you but you. Make a decision today to let it go. That's the first and simplest part that you could do today. No matter what you're going through, no matter what you're feeling, no matter what's on, anything you've heard us say today, you have to decide right here and now that you are not going to let this hold you. Whatever that this is for you, bad relationship, something happened when you was a child and parenting, the way you parent your children, a job, no matter what, whatever that thing is, you have to today make up in your mind that you cannot hold me.
Exactly. So if it's frustration with yourself, your life, mistakes you've made, like you said, I know people that are stuck because they feel like they didn't give 100%. They weren't there for their children the way that they should have been. Or, you know, I didn't do this. I didn't graduate from high school. I didn't whatever, you know, let it go. You know, and one of the ways that you can do that is you need to focus whatever it is that you are discontent about, those things that, you know, you're frustrated with about your life, channel that into like a positive action that counteracts that.
I like
so,
that.
Change channel. What it is. Change.
Well, what do you mean when, I'm sorry, I want people to understand, what does it mean when you say channel?
Focus your attention, basically.
Focused attention.
Yeah. Focus your attention on or channel, use that discontent that you have, right? Whatever that ump is that you have with yourself in a positive way.
Yeah.
So that you can use that for positive action so that you change what it is you don't like about it. Take steps to do things that move you closer towards the direction you want to go.
Right.
You know? The other thing is, if you are dealing with a frustration, you know, with yourself, make a list of accomplishments, you know, of things that you have done right. Even the small things, just, you know, start to focus on those things that you're proud of, the things that you have done right, as opposed to the things that you're frustrated about or the things that you're discontent with in your life, you know?
I like that.
Mm-hmm. The other thing is, think about things that focus your attention also on your energy on things that you can't control, because the reality is the past. So whatever it is you're frustrated with yourself, that you're having a hard time letting go of your mistakes, things like that, you cannot change that. You cannot go back.
It's gone.
So you need to focus on things that you can actually control today instead of dwelling on those things that you can't.
And you can't change the way you felt about it then.
Right.
That hurt.
Exactly.
And you can't change the way you feel about it today. Only thing you could do is push towards a higher mark.
Exactly. There's a quote that says, "Incredible change happens in your life when you decide to take control of what you have the power to do instead of craving control over what you don't."
Why? Oh my God. Why is that? Why do we complain or dwell in those things we have no control over?
I don't know. I just think that, you know, it's something that maybe happened to us, something we did for ourselves, and that hold is so strong. Like I said, we're focused on the past and like, well, I should have done this better. I could have done this better. But no, like the quote says, incredible change happens when you decide to take control, like I said, over what you do have the power of. So the things that you can channel your emotions, your feelings, your discontentment over, things that move you in a more positive direction, or things that you can control, that's when you're really using your power and you're able to let go of those things, and you're using those things as lessons. Like I said earlier, you have the choice. Mm-hmm. You can soak in that stuff, or you can say, yeah, it happened. I can't change it. So I'm going to choose to use it as a lesson going forward.
I found that people in the same situation that you're talking about, where were we at? And sometimes they don't know. This is when they get so angry and they're really upset and they lash out because they don't know how to, as you say, channel. Mm-hmm. They don't even know where to start or who. So they lash out in any kind of argumentative way. They're always mad or bitter. Mm-hmm. You know, they're always upset with everyone else and everything. Something can happen at work, and when they get home, they're lashing out. Something can happen at home, and when they get to work, they're lashing out. They're always upset because they don't know what to do with the thing that truly, sometimes, they have no power to control anyway.
Right. So if it's anger or bitterness that you're struggling to let go of, I would say the first thing is allow yourself to feel it. Just feel it. Feel the emotions, feel the hurt, feel the pain. Like if someone wronged you, did something to you, they hurt you and you're struggling, you know, with anger towards it or bitterness because of it. Just allow yourself to fully feel it and really process it, because if you don't, it's going to keep popping up.
Now, how do we feel it? How, you know, what's a safe way to feel it? Because I may feel it. And I may sit and feel it and then really get mad and I want to go hurt somebody.
See, there's a difference.
Okay.
There's a difference in feeling it and lashing out as a result of those feelings.
Now, in feeling it, wouldn't sometimes it make me feel like going to hurt somebody or do something?
Yeah, but you also have to be responsible for your actions as well. So it's like you have to own it, that this is what happened. This is the way I feel about it. You know, acknowledge those feelings and allow yourself, because sometimes we're angry and bitter with what someone did to us or what happened to us or what we did to ourselves, but we don't sit with it, honestly. We will try to avoid it by keeping ourselves busy,
right,
or, you know, focusing on the anger or whatever it is, or focusing on what the person did. And like you said earlier, trying to somehow shame them, you know, diminish them, whatever, instead of really just focusing on, you know, this happened, whether it was me or someone else, and this hurts me.
Right.
You know, I have regret about this, or I feel hurt, I feel pain about this, and really owning that and acknowledging that, you know, and allowing yourself to feel that. Because if you don't, to sit with it and be real about it, be vulnerable, even with yourself.
Right. So even when you said earlier, and I like this, what you said earlier is even when, you know, you can't control other people and other things, right?
Mm-hmm.
When you sit with it, and what you're telling us is when you sit with it and allow all those feelings and emotions to arise,
mm-hmm,
let them come out, feel what they really are,
mm-hmm,
but at the same time, always being in control.
Exactly.
You have to be in self-control.
Even that is an act of control, where you're saying, I'm going to allow myself to feel this and be vulnerable.
Yeah. And so even before you do it, you have to know it may take you there. It's a process. It may make you feel some kind of way, but no matter what, I'm going to sit right here. I'm going to wait this out. Mm-hmm. And so some people sometimes may need to close themselves off in their home, in their house, or go get a place or do whatever,
or get
for
counseling
some time, because it's a process for some
time.
Because
I need to feel this and process this, because if you do not, it's going to keep popping up. Like you said, you're going to have, even when you think it's gone, you'll be having those conversations and you'll find that it's creeping up in the conversations, or it's creeping up in your actions.
And it is. And that's what people happen. And so they're talking to their friends, their family, they're venting, mm-hmm, I say many times, or ranting,
mm-hmm,
they're doing all this. And so this is what you're saying is sometimes necessary, but they need to do it with a therapist, a counselor, mm-hmm, not your friends,
mm-hmm,
not your parents, not your children.
Exactly. And you mentioned ranting. I would say, you know, with this whole thing, give yourself a ranting window, mm-hmm, so to speak, you know, where I'm going to rant about this. I'm going to feel this. I'm going to soak in this.
Be mindful of who and where you're
exactly
doing it at.
Give yourself, you know, a season to vent, you know, about this, and then take the steps to move on. It's like, I'm not going to stay in this all day. You know, I've heard people say, you know what? I'm going to let myself feel this. They like, I've cried about this 5 days. I'm moving on. I won't cry about it. Whatever it is, give yourself, again, the ability to sit in that season and feel those things and vent and rant. And then you have to move on. Also, then remind yourself that anger and that bitterness, it hurts you more than it does the person that upset you or did this to you.
They moved on.
You know, or even if you're the person that has upset yourself, remind yourself that you already can't let go of what you did to yourself in the past. Now you sitting here holding on to it. You hurting yourself even more. So all you doing is adding to it,
mm-hmm,
right? And so you need to remind yourself of that. You said earlier how it can lead to sickness, illness, whatever. So remind yourself of that if you are really struggling to let go of anger and bitterness.
So I like this. So what we need to do at this point, once we come into ourselves, Mm-hmm. We allow ourselves to sit with our emotions. When we allow ourselves to vent, to rant, to do whatever, now we need to, now, for this moment, this is where we need to look and see what have this taught us. Mm-hmm. What is our experience from this? And again, this is the key, not about other people, not other people that was involved in this, not the persons, not the job, not the relationship, but the I, the me. What have I learned about me mm-hmm. in this experience? And one thing I always say is, how can I not ever feel like this again?
Well, I think about when you say about the experience, I think if you are struggling to let go of past relationships, or relationships that you're currently in that right. you know no longer serves you. You know those relationships are expired, but you're struggling to let go. I think that, like you said, one of the things that you have to do, you have to really sit and identify what this experience taught you, you know, because it's going to help you to move forward. You decide, once again, to let it be a lesson. So whether it's a past relationship and you're struggling to move on, let go, you know, the 2019 of it, or just the hurt that it caused you, or a relationship that you're in and it's expired and it doesn't serve you, just identify, what did I learn from this? What did this experience teach me?
And from that, develop a closure. Mm-hmm. That's how you develop closure.
It gives you a sense of closure, because sometimes you're not going to get closure from people.
Come on, hold on. Woo. I almost start speaking in tongue. Hold on.
Go ahead.
Say that part one more time.
You're not always going to get closure from people. So do not sit around yes. and hold on to stuff, waiting for them to give you closure of some sort before you let it go. No.
Some people have develop apologized your own closure. To you.
And you and still, it still ain't it's enough. Not enough.
Right.
It's not. Yes. Sometimes people will apologize to you. They will apologize to everyone else around you. They will. And it's just not enough. So just take from it, you know, the lesson, and let that be a tool for closure for you. Also, I think when it comes to relationships, a lot of times people tend to romanticize relationships. Mm-hmm. And that's why it's so hard for them to move on or let go, whether it's a past relationship or current relationship. They keep focusing on, you know, the past, and they say, oh, but it was so good. Like 2019 was so good. I just can't let it go. Like, I'm hoping we're going to get back to the days when we were so wonderful and it was so great. And so they just can't let it go. But you need to acknowledge, you know, that past wasn't perfect. If it was a past relationship, you need to mm-hmm. be real about what it was, the sum total of the relationship.
Correct.
Not just the great parts. And the current relationship, you know, you need to be real about where you are in that relationship. You know, when you acknowledge the good as well as the bad, it's easier. It helps you really see where you are. There's a quote that says, it's easier to let go of a human than a hero. Mm. So when you make a person a hero and don't look at them as a human, and you don't see the flaws as well as the good, because that's the thing. A lot of times we stand, people be like, well, we have so much history. I can't walk away. That's history. What about the present? What about the future? Does this align with where you are, where you're trying to go now? And so they look at all those wonderful memories, like, you know, and so it's hard, but they're not, you get, you know, selective amnesia about the reality of some of the hard times, you know, and some of the things that you've actually gone through. So look at it for both the good and the bad. And that's also key on the reverse, because sometimes a person will do a bad thing. They hurt you. And like you said, you just want to nail them to the cross. They have apologized and you just won't let it go. You telling everybody about them to shame them. You don't forget about the good.
Right.
You know, not saying that you don't need to let it go. You need to let that go too. The bad stuff. It's like they've done this thing that is very real to you, and it's caused you hurt, but you've forgotten all about all the good things that they've done as well. So again, look at it from a true perspective. Look at both the good and the bad, and then move on from there.
True. Remind yourself that these are that you have three options, and these options is remove yourself from the situation. You have to remove yourself. Some people, and I say this, talk a good game, and they will tell you he or she is this and that, mm-hmm. but they still creeping. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Or they still have pictures. They're reminiscing over old emails or cards.
You say about the pictures. So before you give them an option, let me say this. You mentioned the pictures. Another thing that you have to do is you have to create a space. Like, you have to create a reality that reflects your present. So if you still got pictures and emails and love letters and teddy bears and all these things around you, get rid of it. Let it go, because those things are holding you too. That makes it hard to let go. So your new space, create a space that reflects your present reality. Let that stuff go.
But that's the thing. On the outs, that's what they're doing and saying to other people as they're renting and talking about mm-hmm. it. But at the same time, people are secretly holding, secretly texting, secretly calling. Mm-hmm. You got to stop. Mm-hmm. You got to stop. Like, what did Erica Badu say about the bus?
You're going to miss your bus.
You're going to miss what God has mm-hmm. for you, still trying to, on one end, crucify the person, but yet you still trying to sneak back with the person.
Well, holding on to hope.
Or in any kind of way.
You know, you got to be careful. Just let it go.
But even if the person's not around, even if they're gone and you're not doing all that, just holding on, as you say, to that past. Mm-hmm. Good, bad, or indifferent. You have to come to accept that a change has come. Mm-hmm.
But you said that if you're holding on to a relationship, you said there's only three options, right?
Right. Remove yourself. Mm-hmm. That's one. From the situation altogether. Mm-hmm. Change it. Mm-hmm. And or accept it.
Right. So you're saying there's three options. You either remove yourself from the situation, you change the situation, or you accept it. Either way, you got to let go of the hurt, the pain, the bitterness, whatever it is, in either one of those. Because you either removing yourself, you leaving that situation, or you going to change it to make it better, or you going to accept it for what it is. But either way, you cannot hold on to all of this hurt, this pain, whatever. But when you do that, when you remind yourself of those options and you take those options, it allows you the freedom to move forward. Let's talk about one more thing, because a lot of people are holding on to stress and they cannot seem to let go of stress. And so if you are struggling to let go of stress, one of the things, I read this a while back where they were saying, use deep breathing techniques. So if you are finding yourself in a moment of stress, do some deep breaths, so it'll soothe you and it helps bring you back to the present. So if you start to see yourself get worked up, start to do some deep breaths, really focus in on that, on your breathing, and it'll soothe you and bring you back down to the present.
That's good, because many people, even from anxiety or stress from these type of things, have panic attacks. Mm-hmm. And so breathing is the key to avoid mm-hmm. these types of panic attack. And I just think it's good to practice this type of intentional breathing anyway.
Yep. If, you know, another thing is with stress is if you're struggling to let it go, you really need to sit down and identify the source of the stress. Really see where the source of that stress is coming from and remove it. If it is like a deep hurt or pain or whatever, like we said earlier, get the counseling, do what you need to do so that you're able to move on for it. I saw a quote that says, worry pretends to be necessary, but serves no useful purpose. And it's so true, because what has worry ever gotten anyone? Mm.
If you don't worry, don't pray.
But it's like you worry about it, and then what does that do? It doesn't change anything. So, you know,
it just really took away from you.
It took precious time. It took energy away from you. And so really think about the source of the stress and then just move it out of your way or do what you need to do to get beyond it.
Yes. Philippians 3:14 moves on and says, I move forward towards the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Jesus Christ. Yes. What is it saying? Press towards your mentally, physically, freedom. Mm-hmm. Press towards a peace within yourself. Press towards a better relationship with who? With yourself. Mm-hmm. And when you do that, you will find a better relationship with others. Press towards a continued personal growth. Mm-hmm. Where, like we said, you had to learn something. Look at what mm-hmm. you learned in this experience. Don't just go from relationship to relationship or job to job or whatever is causing you stress mm-hmm. and don't learn, grow.
Listen, you know what I'm about to say. It's like Jacob. I'm not going to let you go till you bless me. If I had to go through this stress or whatever it was, this hurt, this pain, I might as well take something from it.
Yeah, but even when you look at Leah, how long? Mm-hmm. How long did you settle? And this is a lot of people's story. How long did you settle with somebody that didn't even want you?
Mm-hmm. Listen, that's the thing. You have to decide, what are you holding on to, really? You know?
When do you plan to let it go? If you haven't thought about it, hope this podcast, you know, resonates in your spirit. When do you plan to let it go?
And how do you plan to get there? Mm.
And at the same time, if the reason is you, why haven't you forgiven yourself?
Mm-hmm.
Where are you going? And how do you plan to get there? These are all powerful things. If you're stuck in the past, let the past go. 2019, people, we're not going back.
It's gone.
We're not going back. Everything is new. Everything is changing. You know, I hate that the sickness that people have got. I hate that the people that we have lost. But if we look at society overall, there is some good new changes that are taking place on how things are happening. So let the past go. If you're holding on to some thoughts of evil and revenge,
please let it go.
Quit walking around angry, upset, mad, just all the time. As I say, you're angry with something at home and you're taking it out at work, and you're angry with something at work and you're taking it out at home. Let it go. If you are fighting some type of addiction,
please.
An addiction can be anything. It don't have to be drug and alcohol.
Right.
If you're addicted to people,
mm-hmm.
Ooh, some of us are addicted to people, or, you know, my line, addicted to your story.
Mm-hmm.
You need to let it go.
Yep.
If you're feeling depressed and stressed, as we talked about, if any of these things that we talked about today made you or you find yourself depressed and stressed about it and in a dark place, I'm going to say, like Erica Badu, let it go, let it go, let it go. You have to let it go. If someone has angered you,
let it go.
Someone have upset you,
mm-hmm.
Please, you better let it go. You got to let it go, because
you're doing yourself
anger,
a disservice.
Yes,
it's not even about them at this point.
If you have a bad attitude, just because, no matter what, if you just nasty, if your attitude is just bad, what do you need to do?
Let it go.
If you are holding on to past hurts and pains, and this is the key, if you are holding on to things that are hurting you and has caused you some pain, please do what?
Let it go.
If you are holding on to a job that no longer meets your needs or talents, please
let it go.
If you are in a ministry, come
ooh,
on now.
Come on now.
If you are in a ministry that have you that you have outgrown,
yeah,
or if you are pastoring or ministering and ushering past your season, what she say? Let it go, let it go, let it go, let it go. If you keep trying to help someone who won't even try to help themselves.
Ooh, please let them go. That's a bag you don't even have to carry. Let them carry their own bag.
Woo! If someone can't treat you right, love you back, and see your worth,
find the good and goodbye.
Let them go. Let them go. If you are struggling with a broken relationship right now, if you are listening to this podcast and know that that relationship is broken, all you must hold on to is you. You can let them go.
Yes.
That house, that car, whatever financials you think they got,
let
you holding
go,
on.
Let it go. Yes, I read a quote that says, to let go does not mean to get rid of. To let go means to let be.
Right.
When we let be with compassion, things come and go on their own. And that literally reminds me of the Serenity Prayer. The Serenity Prayer says, God, and I'm going to say it for all of us, God, grant us the serenity to accept the things we cannot change, courage to change the things that we can, and the wisdom to know the difference. Let it go
free yourself, continue to grow, and go live that life now.
Let it go, let it go, let it go, let it go. Are you a corporation in need of coaching and training?
A church or nonprofit that's seeking speakers, coaching, or training services?
Conference organizer in need of a keynote speaker?
Or a couple seeking relationship, premarital, or marital counseling or coaching?
Great. You're a part of our C Factor. That Life is a faith-based firm that provides speaking, coaching, training, and consultant services.
Are you ready to be about that life?
That Life specializes in helping individuals and organizations create transformational shifts that help them transition from caterpillars to beautiful butterflies.
And we're looking to connect with decision makers who are booking upcoming retreats, conferences, or trainings.
We are also available for group or one-on-one coaching and consultant services.
Please contact us for a free consultation at livethatlifenow@gmail.com. And remember to live that life now.